Hi everyone, I'm Cinderay9. Welcome back to Let's Play Jade Cocoon. So, I'm gonna merge a patron with Radgor. One less defense, one more magic defense, gains a level, 19 HP, 4 mana. And that's what it'll look like. So, we're gonna go ahead and do that. The reason I'm doing this is that way it can learn Valus, which is the hit all enemies with a water attack, which could come in handy, even though the magic attack isn't as good as the attack. I think it'll still be handy to have. So, let's merge them.
Oh, magical beasts who serve us, merge thy flesh to gain yet greater power.
Reveal to us thy heroic form! And we're gonna name this Radtron, because it's a mixture of the two. So, why not? I'm terrible with names, by the way. Want to try merging some more? No, I think I'm okay. As for spinning, I span the two Radmoles and a few other older minions.
I know I
shouldn't have skipped that. Mabu says, I know I shouldn't be complaining while you're out fighting in the forest. You have a right to complain, Mabu. This is what you get for marrying a silent protagonist. We have two great walnuts, so we're gonna use one. Yay! 105 HP. That's good. Lily Silk is what we got from the two Radmoles. Gives off a dazzling shine, fifth highest grade of silk. Interesting. And I just noticed that I kind of messed up the intro. I didn't say blind. I don't think I did that in the last video either. Huh. I need to remember to do that. Anyway, let's go sell this new silk and see how much we get for it. Hi. Shop. Let's sell. So, Thunder Silk is 225, which we know. Mitz Vague is Titania's Flashes of Light, 6th highest grade of silk. The Lily Silk, as it gives off a dazzling shine, 5th highest grade, 375, so that's nice. So, if you can, instead of grinding in the Dragonfly Forest like I did, because I didn't want to see anything new, of course, if you're playing the game, go to the Spider Forest, get some of the newer, you know, the new minions we've seen, and you get more, money from spending that silk. So, definitely do that to save up the money to buy the armor supplies here, like mugwort, or meta mugwort, or liquors, or etc., etc. Especially the armor and weapons, because they are expensive. And three more of those. Let's do that. Yes, yes. Okay. Let's head back. Well, first. First, I should take my own advice from last episode and I should save. I'm usually really good about saving, but for some reason in Jade Cocoon, I don't know what it is. I've just been forgetting to save. So we'll go ahead and do that. And now we'll head back to the forest. So, for those of you that have played this game, I have a question for both sides. So don't feel left out if if you haven't played this game like me. For those of you that have played this game, how much merging of minions did you do? Did you do it a lot? I don't feel like I'm doing it that much. And I don't know why. I'm just, you know, attached to the minions that I have. I like the way they look. I like the skills they have. Right now, maybe I'll see more. And I summoned the wrong minion. Why did I do that? Did you merge a lot? Do you see me doing it more later? Is it just something just because of where I'm at in the game? Or just throughout the game, did you not merge all that much? I'm kind of curious. And for those of you that haven't played the game, but have been watching, what do you think your approach would be? Would it be kind of like mine? I'm not merging that much. Or would you be trying to mix and match all kinds of minions and really, really trying to do a lot with it? Because I could see there's a lot of potential there for the merge system, and I'm sure there's a lot, but I don't know. I'm just kind of sticking with the base, kind of three base elements right now, and I want them to be really strong in it. I know a few of you have said I should try to mix it up and have more than one element on a minion. I don't know. I've always been one that likes specialist. So, I don't know. We got another great walnut, so let's use that. I'm curious. What would your approach be if you were LPing this game? Or playing this game? Let's do it that way, because I know not all of you are LPers. So, and that it's different. It really is. If you were just playing this game, would you be doing the merge system a lot? Or would you be more, I guess in a way you could say, conservative? How I'm playing. I'm curious. Now let's get you EXP. So let me know in the comments if A, you've played or you haven't, and B, what your strategy with the merge system would be. As I try to get back to where we were, at least trying to do it somewhat quickly. Water attack. There we go. Yeah. Really starting to see the power of that. Really like it. So that's just working well. Another thing that I really haven't shown off with the merge system, and you may want to take this into account, it, depending on how you merge the minions, it's not just about the look of the minions, but the other thing it does, other than the look and the abilities, it messes with the stats. I've noticed that, and that's why I haven't really been doing too much of the merging. Ikari powder picked up. Is that a hint, game? But like with our patron, for example, I really didn't merge him too much, or I didn't want to merge him at all, just because I noticed that it seemed like whatever I merged him with, I was losing speed, and I wanted to keep that. I was not just losing speed, but losing a lot of stats. I don't know if it's just how I was merging him, but I would try both ways, having him be the first part and the second part. And yes, it matters. It matters the order that you merge the minions as well. And that was just something I was noticing, so I really liked his stats. Am I off for doing that? I don't know. Again, this is blind. So I don't know if there's, you know, some greater strategy that I'm missing out on when it comes to that. Turtle levels up plus 2 attack, plus 1 defense, magic attack, and magic defense, 16 HP and 2 mana. And I see a tablet. Divine tablet picked up. Oh, that sounds... sounds really handy, but we'll see just how good it is. Divine tablet. Some tablet engraved with the story of creation tells of profound truths. Am I gonna need that? Wait. The spider person wants something valuable, right? Maybe that's the valuable gift that I have to give. You look very interesting. We're capturing you. Dog Hambu. Dog Hambu? Doge Hambu? I'm not sure. All I know is Flame Wasp has your weakness, so... Let's Agnes. See how much you can do. Ooh. Took that pretty well, I gotta say. Do it again. That's good. I should be able to capture. Let's try. And I'd like to have them both again. One to merge with, maybe, and then one to maybe turn into silk. Capture. Good, that's one. And because of our fast speed now, we can capture the other one. Thank you, little bird. I appreciate that so much that you give a lot of speed. That's something else. I guess this is kind of the viewer interaction episode. As I explore this new place, trying to find things to talk about, to be honest. Another mirror of Deva. I believe we have one of those already. How do you like your minion? Another great walnut, yay. Oh, 3 HP that time. Up to 110. Nice. How do you like your minion? Yeah, we have that already. Protection from all. All status effects. Do you like your minion? Oh, there's a way we can go here. Interesting. Hi! Hold that thought. You kind of look like... Okay, no. It's a...
A flute man! Give me!
Give you... Spearhead fell off! Gimme! Give me something sharp, flute man! Show him how to ask politely. Give him the minion fang. We have a minion fang? When did I get... Tell him you have nothing to give. Show him how to ask politely.
Ow! Don't hit me! Don't need that math!
Really? That's... well... I guess I shouldn't expect too much more from a silent protagonist. I guess he says he can't speak and show his bonk. That's a terrible way to teach. Levant? Darn it! Merging 2 picked up. Oh, hey, that could come in handy. Well, that was terrible. Good job, Levant. Way to completely screw that up. Yay, he came back. Hi. Minion Fang.
Useless flute man. I'm fine by myself. Humph.
I guess I don't have that. Fine. Be mean. Let's go try to find a Minion Fang then. Actually, it would probably be under valuables, wouldn't it? Now, let's also read this Merging 2 tablet. Minions that use poison are also resistant to it. Oh. Merging such a minion with another creates a new poison-resistant beast. The same also applies to minions with sleep and flush-to-stone attacks. Huh. Well, there's more to merging than meets the eye. Of course there is. That's interesting. Huh. Being resistant to that flesh to stone, flesh to stone, would be really helpful. Hi! We're capturing one of you. Oh, great. Now there's one earth and one air. Huh. It'd be really bad if it was like one earth and one fire. Because then no matter what I summoned, they'd be strong to one, but weak to one. Interesting. But since that isn't the case, what we're going to do, we're going to summon Flame Wasp. And we're going to take care of the one on the right. The Doghambu. The fire attack. Oh, stone. Great. Okay, let's get rid of you quickly then. Oh, come on. I say that and then you miss. Good job, Flame Wasp. Now, watch Flame Wasp, by the way. He'll turn more and more gray. I bet after this turn, he may turn into stone. That's kind of my guess, anyway. If he lives, which it kind of looks like he's not going to. Well, this will be a good time to do an experiment. Let's get Levant back out here. Let's capture you. Come here. You know, if I could have four minions instead of three, I could have all of the bases covered, and that'd be really good. Oh, great! The last thing we need is Levant turned to stone. So, let's summon a new minion. I guess you, Steel Turtle, because you're not weak to... You're not weak to Earth, so... And here's the other thing that confuses me about... having more than one element. Yes, I can see the benefits of it. So let's say you're crit. Thanks for that. Let's say you're earth and wind, for example. Let's do that. So yes, you now have that air element to fight. Gee, quit missing. You now have that air element to take on earth enemies, right? Oh, and you just insta-die when you're turned to stone. That is terrible! Go ahead and capture! I thought it just, you know, well, I guess because status effects don't last beyond battle, huh? Still, that's terrible! Great. That caught me completely off guard. Now I forgot what I was talking about. Good job, Syndrel. Oh, yes. More than one element. But then wouldn't you be... That's a bad example. Let's do... I'm going to stay on the screen for a second. Let's do Earth and Fire. So let's say you're Earth and Fire and you're split. Now... You should be strong to water, right? Let's say you're fighting a water minion. The earth part of you is strong to water. But then the fire side is weak to water. So that would wash out, right? I don't see the great benefit of that. Maybe I'm just not looking at it. At it right, and sometimes that happens when you're playing a game and recording and doing more than one thing at a time, but I don't know, I just don't see how that helps you a lot in that case. Spider warp picked up, yay! Found this one. Where does this take us? Excuse me. Another place with a save point. Ah, yes, experiment time. So, we have these liquors, right? Restores minion HP and mana. Do they also revive? Nope. I kind of think they didn't. I think you need this. This revives your minions, which they're really, really expensive. They're 1,500 apiece, so that's... How much was it? 375? They're 4 of the new silk that we got from this area. That's expensive, so don't let your minions get turned to stone and or faint. That's bad. Where is this anyway? Where are we? Oh, okay. That's what this... Oh, okay. That's good. So, tell you what, we're going to fight this, and because we have that warp there, what we're going to do is... We'll head back to town, and then we can use the warp to get back to where we were. Or we can continue looking at that right side. Let's do that. That sounds more apt. We'll do that. Thankfully, our minion Rattron is really strong. Do I want to capture you and turn you into silk? Not really. I'd rather have the EXP at this point. So let's do that. Okay. Alright, now. We can just leave the forest. Could have used the earring, but I mean, we're right here, so why not? Step one, revive fainted. Are they fainted minions? Let's assume they're not dead.
I'm sorry, I just felt so strange. I need to be more like a cocoon master's wife.
That's what Mabu's thinking. Now this we've heard. I'm so used to just fast forwarding through Mabu's speeches. because it's the same thing we've heard dozens of times now. Okay, let's spin. We got three of these. They're very interesting. We're gonna spin one. And we got another Radgor. Let's spin it. Let's do that. By the way, there is a limit to the number of cocoons that a number of minions that Mabu can have. Thank you, Mabu. Because I tried to exit one time off camera when I was doing all the grinding to get silk for the short sword and armor we have now. And she's like, I can't carry this much. Maybe that'll happen now. I don't know if it's as you progress in the story, she can hold more. I'm not sure. Oh, see, here we go. Perfect timing, Mabu. Thanks. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm all out of space. I can't store any more cocoons. I can spin to get rid of some. So yes, you either have to merge or spin cocoons at this point. So, great. I guess we could spin some of the older cocoons. Sure. You're one of the ones I merged, but that's okay. Spin those. So yes, be aware that Mabu can only carry so many... have so many minions stored, so... be wary of that, by the way. We need to rearrange. There we go.
I know.
Did it again. Hold on. I want to have Mabu say that for all of you, because you've not heard it yet.
But thank you. I'm so glad to have someone to talk to.
Oh, she hasn't said that before.
I feel a lot better now.
Oh, that's good. Guess because I haven't talked to her twice in a row like that.
I know I shouldn't be complaining while you're out fighting in the forest.
It's easy to feel bad for Mabu, and I do too. I remember when she purifies, it hurts. She's exhausted. At this point, she's purified enough to where she has, I guess, markings appearing on her body. If you can believe what the gossipers say. But, let's not forget what Levant's doing. He's risking life and limb out there in the forest to save the village. Sometimes when you have a silent protagonist, and this is why I do try to take a step back and kind of look at things. I try. I don't say I always do, but I do try. It's easy to forget about the character that you're playing as and the struggles that he's going through. So think about, you know, and of course, Mabu has every right to feel the way that she does. But don't forget about Levant, who's all of a sudden, his father's gone, and now he's thrust into this role of basically saving the village. With, other than that, that man we met in the first forest has had very little guidance, and Garai. But when he's out there in the forest, he has very little guidance, very little help other than the three minions he can take with him. There's... And if he dies, that's it. So, don't forget about poor Levant either. Like I said, sometimes it's easy to forget when they're a silent protagonist. Oh, hey, you're an Earth one. Ooh. I must have. Summon. I really like these little dragon-looking minions. They just seem to have a really good balance, and they hit pretty hard, at least the one that Rattron does. Let's... You don't have any magic. Earth attack. Excuse me. Oh, haven't seen that. I like that. I like that Earth spell. That's pretty cool. It's different. Usually it's just like a boulder falling down or something, but... And they have them kind of explode like that. That's cool. I like that. Join us. Yay, alright. You'll be in the party sooner than later. Wonder if I can get like a fire one to show up. That'd be really cool. No. I'm gonna end up killing some time here, so I do apologize. There's Earth. I wonder if it's just water and Earth. That's really neat, though. So you may want to go back to areas and... I don't think we've seen this too much, but the element can change. Here's a really good example. Want another one. Just in case. Yeah. Excuse me. Hit. Oh, whoa, you got like a tail slap? That's cool. Don't die. The other one didn't do that. I wonder if they have different moves. Like, you could capture the same minion. Like, these are, what, Red Doggles? Anyway, if you capture the same minion twice, we've seen they can have different stats. I believe I showed that off in one of the early videos. But can they have different abilities? I didn't even think about that. Figured they'd all have the same... If they're the same level, they'd have the same abilities. But maybe not. Huh. Capture level 11. No title change. Didn't really expect one. Very interesting. Let's take a quick look at this... this right path here. What do we have here? Oh, we got different music. Huh. Hello. Oh, hi. Aww. It's got a bow! And, is speaking in a higher pitched voice, so I'm assuming you're a, little female? Whatever species this is. Oh, it's cute! Me hungry! Me want Kinkleberry! Gimme! We actually have that, though! Yeah, sure, here! You can have it.
What's this? Kinkleberry! Mmm! Yummy!
Ask about Yamu. Ask about the Calabasar. Oh, now she's listening. Do you know anything about the Calabasar?
Calabasar? Don't know. What's that? Yummy?
That's adorable. It really is. Like a kid, though, so I guess she wouldn't know. Yummy? Maybe. What do you know about... I'm gonna assume maybe it's your brother?
Yamu? Big brother! Me, Yummy!
Okay.
Yummy!
So... he gives you lots of yummy things. Of course, he's a big brother, he should. You gotta look out for your younger siblings. Yummy? Oh, if that didn't put a smile on your face, I don't know what to tell you. That's adorable. Okay, gotta go now, bye.
No, yummy. No more. Too bad.
Aww. That was all sad. Yeah, I only had one, Yami. I'm sorry. Tablet with teeth half covered in dirt. She tried to eat it. The other one had a hole in it from Yamu's spear, I'm gonna assume. This one, Yami tried to eat. She's hungry! Okay, let's see what this knowledge has before we wrap up this episode. While turning to stone, your body gets harder with each turn, eventually leading to death. Oh, wow, I really wish I had this tablet, I don't know, what, 20 minutes earlier or something? Accuracy and avoidance will decrease while body hardens. That's why we were missing so much. Aha. So, not. I figured avoidance. That's. I wouldn't say typical, but it happens more often than not. With this eventual petrification stuff, your avoidance goes down as your body hardens, which makes sense. You can't dodge as much. But. Having the accuracy go down isn't typical to me in my experience. Very interesting. We'll have to keep that in mind. Aww. We still need to find that minion fang, though. That way we can give it to Yamu. Being the older one, he may have more of an idea of where the Calabas herb is. Or at least point me in the right direction. Ooh, treasure chest. We did get that skeleton key from the, Yeah. We did get the skeleton key from the poacher. Yeah, why not? Let's use it here. We'll summon... We can get the turtle. So actually, I should get Flame Wasp some experience because now it's the lowest level out of everybody. So we'll do that. We'll just weaken here. And I guess one more hit, then we'll switch. I really like the tail attack. I think that's cool. Let's switch now. Yeah, see, only level 8, so some experience would help out. There we go. Some fine liquor, nice. Oh, look at that. Like close to half a level, nice. Remember, the bars are about twice the size, so. Let's use one of the skeleton keys. Stone choker. Multi-seal 2, 3 of them. Multi-seal 1, 5 of them. Alright, let's look at the loot and then we'll end this episode. Multi-seal 2. Attack multiple enemies with wind, and multi-seal 1 is just one enemy with wind. We've had those before. Okay. Stone choker. Releases clean air, increases resistance against, increases resistance against flesh to stone. It doesn't give that ton of magic attack that the silver crown does, though. Helps focus mana. Yeah, no joke. Helps focus mana, but you don't cast Levant, so does that work on your minions? I'm still confused about that. Why Levant has a magic attack stat when Levant doesn't cast magic? Is it just for his is it for these? Is it for the seals? If that's the case, then you only get so many. I don't know, that still confuses me. The resistance against flesh to stone is tempting. We're gonna keep this with us for sure. So, not bad. We still have a spare key, which is good and bad, because from what that means is I guess I missed a treasure chest somewhere, because we've had enough keys to open the treasure chest in the area. So, I missed a treasure chest somewhere, but I do have a spare key for another area. So, look on the bright side of things, right? So that's going to do it for this episode. We kind of explored this right path here. Next time we're going to take this teleporter right here, because the party's good. You need some HP, but that's okay. I think we're okay there. Well, I could go back to town. Because town's right here, I'm going to go back to town, and I'm probably going to merge our new Earth friends with this guy. Kind of see how it works out. We'll see how it works out. Either way, next time we're going to continue going through the Spider Force. We'll take that left path and see what we can find over there. So, until then, thank you very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Had a lot of fun. I'm Cinder89. Remember to shoot for the stars and take care, everyone.